Hello, and thank you for joining me. Over the past 3 months, I've brought you music from 18 composers of 10 nationalities. For the first time, all of the composers featured in tonight's programme were born in different countries. So we have a kind of Eurovision, with representation from England, France, Germany, Italy, Poland, and New Zealand. Germany kicked things off with their entry by Siegfried Kargelert, his famous improvisation on the hymn tune, Now Thank We All Our God. Next up, we have three examples of a style broadly termed trumpet tune. These are all written in a question and answer format between the solo reed stop and the general organ accompaniment. The first one is by a composer named Tommaso Albinoni, an Italian composer writing at the same time as Bach. He was relatively unique in that he never sought a church or court position, owing to the money left by his father's business. As such, his compositions are free from outside influence and were generally composed for his own enjoyment. You likely know him from the infamous Adagio for Organ and Strings, which was attributed to Albinoni, but in fact written by his 20th century biographer. The second piece is by John Stanley, who resides among the ranks of great organists who were either born blind or became blind at an early age. He relied on a remarkable memory, which allowed him to hear a complete stage work once through and subsequently play the entire accompaniment. He was appointed organist at a London church at the age of 11, reportedly on a salary equivalent to $4,500 in today's money. His music contains good scope within a relatively limited range of style. Closing the trio is C.S. Lang's famous tuba tune. It begins in the style of Handel, but wanders into brief tonal shifts typical of the 20th century. Lang avoided using heavy-handed harmonies, the result being a lovely marriage of the two styles. You can vote for your favourite of these three trumpet tunes in the live chat. Thank you. We move to the piano now for two waltzes by Chopin. The first is written in the minor and communicates a deep melancholy which gently melts into a lighter character only to return to the original sonority. The second, written in the major, exhibits a sense of playfulness which, despite some restrained moments, never fully settles down. Chopin's style of waltz is intended for concert performance rather than dancing, a marked departure from the Viennese style which came before. Last month, we heard a rather solemn fugue by Lefebvre Wellé. His compositions were less substantial and less musically interesting than that of his contemporaries, and as such, they don't hold as prominent a place in the repertory. Despite this, he was a virtuosic performer who played to his audiences. In other words, he knew the kind of thing people wanted to hear, and he staunchly played it in the face of critics who demanded more serious music. This final piece is a prime example of that popularist spirit. As always, thank you for watching.